Good evening, friendos. It's time for Quest for Semi-Glory Thursday Night Shmup Book Club. Probably gonna focus exclusively on V5 tonight. I just can't be arsed to get Crimson Clover set up. And plus, I like this game a whole lot. So let's get connected up to the club. Looks like we got a good full house tonight. It's gonna be a lot of fun.
You just pop in the call because OBS puts you there.
Yeah, no, actually, what's funny is I opened OBS, then went out of the room, then came back like, oh shit, did it put me in the call? No, it didn't. Okay, fine.
Don't worry, it happens incredible. To the best of us.
Oh, there he is.
And the worst of us.
Hello.
Good evening.
It was the best of times, it was the blurst of times.
Oh, so yeah.
You stupid monkey.
Oh, so what's up?
I found out someone posted on Reddit they got like a 1.1 trillion in Crimson Clover Novice.
Oh.
Apparently someone else runs a Shmup Book Club and they're doing it for their monthly.
Oh! What? Fucking intruding on my turf!
Wait, what? Wait, you're saying someone else actually does do a Shmup Book Club?
Yes, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Well, they're fucking jerks.
Who would
Mine
be stupid enough to do? I mean,
That's all I'm. That's my official stance on it. Whoever did that is a jerk, and mine is better anyway. So there.
You know, not having any stake in this game, I would be inclined to agree.
Thanks. Glad to get the vote of confidence there.
Boop, boop, boop.
I mean, mine features participant interactivity, and also a call every week. Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Two.
Yeah, I did like do research on this their Shmup Book Club. So
let's not die to the same missile.
You
again.
Didn't or did?
Did not. I can't say what it offers.
Well, mine is better because it features cool people. So
it
there.
Doesn't offer chumpos.
Strong players.
Yeah, that has a severe lack of chumpos, doesn't it? That's right. Mine has more chumpos than you can eat.
I got butt clipped by a
But you're gonna eat them anyway.
Really
but
mad.
You are gonna eat them.
Oh no,
that
right. sucks.
You'll fucking eat them.
Alright, I started the stream right after that, which I find unfortunate because it would have been pretty funny if I started it right before that.
Oh, that you'll fucking eat it bit?
Yeah.
That would have been a strong start, though.
Oh yep. Man, it would have been real good. That's one for the that's one for the VOD. That's one to preserve for all time. That's
one,
right, you'll fucking eat it.
That's one for the best of clip, right?
Alright, time to go find the link because I forgot to put it in my stream title and also open it and then hack it so that I only see the chat.
Oh, do you just do it so it only views the right side?
Do you just use, like, fucking dev tools to delete all of the other HTML? That's kind of beautiful. That's a delightfully janky.
If I were smart, I would make a damn Chrome extension to do it.
That seems like a lot of work, though.
That's a lot, yeah.
It
that's
probably
exactly.
isn't, but it is for me because I've never done a Chrome. Well, actually, I probably have done a Chrome extension once and I forget how it works, but it's probably not that hard.
I don't know.
Yeah, I know I was bored. I know I was bored at work today, but I started grinding Z code.
I'm so sorry.
So, wait, is this basically the most literal interpretation of Michael Lopp's bored people quit?
Son of a bitch. Okay, I'm ran over. And right over my head and put in my cables.
Don't do that. You're gonna break them.
Jeez.
I've run over them like a million times. I usually immediately catch when I stop doing it and pull off them.
Coward.
That's not the right link. I picked the wrong link out of the topic.
Oh, did you? You grabbed the. You grabbed
hey,
the
everybody, here's a Google Doc to look at instead of the stream.
To the info doc, they'll know all about what's going on with this Garbo. This hot Garbo.
Does it explain Shumpos now?
No.
Well, then that's like the one purpose it had, and that was really the most important part.
I feel like I should probably make like some sort of info doc for some of the dumb like inside joke meme shit.
High concept, yeah.
High concept. Wilson turret.
Very important.
Puyo Crimes Room, which is now a thing.
The Puyo Crime Room.
Yeah, it's the room with four Puyos at the beginning of it, and some in the middle with the Batuun E-Tank after Batuun in Super Metroid.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Well, I feel like you're going to have to take that up with the Super Metroid community to adopt that.
They're not going to give a crap about Puyo Crimes.
Yeah, that's because they're lame and shitty. I mean, Johnny. Whoa.
He just. Jeez. Kenny, you just need to keep fucking
smoky
harsh.
Would be a thing, because Kenny, the Smoky just names rooms.
Say what?
Smoky just, like, names rooms. Like, that's what he
that's
does.
That's true.
Okay.
Yeah, what is their name for. I forget what Smokey's name for the vertical room before Ridley is.
The shitty room. I don't know.
I do now have full power, so
yay. The slightly shorter shafts. Open for interpretation, of course.
Lewd.
Phrasing? Are we still doing that?
No, apparently we're not.
Nah.
Oh.
Damn, you hate to see it, really.
Oh.
Right,
I just
okay.
Played chicken with the bullet.
I'm looking up into that room right now because.
No! I'm surprised! It should have!
I bet it turned first, though, huh?
I'm pretty sure I just accidentally played chicken with a missile.
Beauty, are you looking forward to watching me play chicken with every single enemy fighter in the existence of Ace Combat 7?
You're gonna have to pee. You're gonna have to beat my feet of dropping a bomber on my head.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know if I can beat that. That's an impressive level of expertise.
It wasn't like even intentional. That's the best part. Like I was just like, oh, I shot this bomber down. I'm gonna fly. I should be good to fly under. I'm going fast enough. Bonk.
Nope.
Nice.
You're dead.
What a killer cell phone.
It was a beautiful cell phone.
Oh, die!
I mean, everyone loves a good old fashioned cell phone. Oh.
They're the best.
I was moving way too much for that. That is the best.
Okay, I finally have that set up.
I'm looking forward to seeing your opinions on the story, EI.
I'm sure it's going to be just as, like, ham fisted as any other Ace Combat story.
They haven't said war is bad in K.
They hadn't done what? Blah, blah, blah?
So far, they haven't said war is bad in K.
Have
you
said
probably
war
just
doesn't
play
change?
Far enough.
I'm 5 missions from the end. Like, they'd have to do. They have to go pretty hard.
I mean. Project Aces is known to veer very hard into the, like, soapbox zone.
I am doing some sketchy things.
So I remembered Smokey's name for the vertical room in Lower Norfair is Santa Poco, because it's got the three amigos in it.
Oh.
Oh. I didn't even notice that one. Whoops. Oh well.
Alright, well, I'm trying to abuse things to get points, but I just keep dying. I need to remember to bring a shield into that section.
That was not smart.
I could not give a shit. Instead, I've kind of ruined myself.
Oh no.
I mean, film at 11, I know, but.
Go lasers, please.
Oh, the bot noises.
It wouldn't be a species stream without them.
Yeah, so that's the other thing that other person's book club doesn't have.
Yeah, fucking Bond noises or everyone else's noises, because let's be honest, all of us make our fair share of noises on this stream.
God damn it.
Yeah.
Bonds are just the most excited, I think.
They have a lot of energy to them. Yeah.
I'm looking forward to all sorts of Bond noises come,
That's gonna be a long
time. Life.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
There's gonna be several different instances of Bond noises happening.
Yeah, I'm kinda curious how that, combo rando is gonna go, because he got pretty freaking pissed at the one you guys did.
Oh, come on, there was other stuff going on that one.
yeah, that wasn't just the rando.
I think cool. Bond had been pre-gaming pretty hard, though.
Yeah, absolutely.
Bond
was very
extremely
drunk.
Pre-gamed.
Ah, fuck.
I was toasty. Bond was toasty.
Oh, man, I was quite
warm. Whoops, that was dumb. Speaking of toasty,
Bond was toasty for Wisconsin.
That's true.
Something.
That does take
a
little bit of effort.
You fucker! You shot one last bit. I hate it. Fuck. Bond was Wisconsin toasty, which is an excessive level of toasty.
Yeah.
Like, VVV toasty.
VVV toasty?
V Toasty.
What's my fucking pause button? There it is.
But what about V5 Toasty?
That is one toasty too little.
Yeah, it's more toasty than that.
This game is 5B or Gridstormer. It is the arcade version.
Grindstormer?
Grindstormer.
My bad.
I mean, all the letters were there.
5B, right?
Yes, I did say 5B.
I got so distracted by looking over the chat to see that comment that I tried to find today.
You're welcome.
Alright, everybody dies.
You're welcome.
I am a professional video game player, I swear, guys.
This is what I do. I did say.
I mean, it's not the Shmup Book Club stream without people distracting each other to death.
Yeah,
I get one colossally stupid joke a week that gets the eye killed or something.
Fucker.
It is hilarious.
Fucking jerk. What did I do to deserve this anyway?
You created this?
Alright, that's
this
a fair
upon
point.
Yourself.
That's a fair point. I can't argue with that logic.
I remember the genesis of the Shmup Book Club. I was there for it.
Yeah, so was I.
I don't remember exactly what the discussion was, but I remember it basically being like...
Huh. I died there.
I don't know, Vita, you'll probably remember it better than I will.
We were talking at one point, and it was like, you like playing shmups, and we're like, we like playing shmups, and we're not good, and we're like, you should do a thing where you just play shmups, like, and try and get better at them.
Yeah.
Like, a book club or something. And then, like, can we? And then it was like, can we think of a better name? We're like, no.
No.
Wow, what a great story.
It is accurate.
It turns out one of the hardest things in programming is also one of the hardest things in establishing a group.
Naming shit.
Yeah. Oh god, funny story today though. I asked a coworker to review a thing and he was very confused, and by a particular line that, to be fair, I should have like commented the expectations better, and like, yeah, ideally your code is self-documenting, but the conditions were...
That's a meme.
That's a myth.
The conditions were complex enough that it was like, no, this isn't gonna make sense no matter how I code it, but like, he pulled out the age-old, maybe if you store this in a variable, it will be more readable. And like, that is often a thing, but in this case, it just colossally didn't make sense. I was like, what do I even name the variable here? And then I came up with like some name that was like 10 words put together. I'm like, this doesn't help.
Yes. It's
call it Bob then.
It's the put all of the data together that does the thing that this very specific and weird edge case that I need to handle variable.
Also, I apparently forgot to take power there, so I guess I'm taking shield instead.
So the Bob variable.
Yeah. I mean, I remember people telling apocryphal stories about naming all the variables after like Flintstones characters and shit like that. And having worked in the biz for a while now, yeah, I'd believe that. Sometimes you just have no idea what this thing is. And it's just, I don't know, it's Fred
now. If you have variable names, that's nice. I just name all my shit like X and Y because I don't give a fuck.
Yeah, I'm
never hiring you then.
I'm pretty sure if I reviewed your code, I'd be like, what the fuck is this? Get this out of here.
Yeah, there was someone in one of the open source communities that I used to... In one of the open source communities I used to be active in, there was a guy who would just like intentionally name variables as short names as possible, and everybody else was like, why the fuck are you doing that? Like, please can you not?
I'm saving memory.
Full ass shit.
Because the compiler gives a shit.
For the if you need to save memory for your compiler, you've done a whole lot of other terrible things. Well, you've done a whole lot of other terrible things, and you should just reconsider all of your life choices up to that point.
Many choices have been made poorly.
That is a sign that your everything is beyond repair, and you should just quit the industry. Because you've done a... sit above the bug. Oh, that's neat enough, I guess.
Oh.
I don't know how I survived that.
I don't feel like the shots the bug shoots are enough of an issue for me to be worried about it, though, is the problem. Like, yeah, it shoots a carpet of things, but it's a carpet of things that's all pointed at one thing, so you just move, like, 4 inches to the right, and you're fine.
Well, I mean, if you're doing for loops, you just name it all. It's all fucking I and J.
I mean, okay. Single-letter variables for for loops is a generally accepted practice.
Yeah, like anonymous loop variables, that's a fucking practice, yo.
Because it makes sense, because you're usually there's an obvious thing that's happening, and so I is obviously the index into whatever thing you're doing for your loop or your counter or whatever. Like, it's whatever. It's fine. It's usually obvious from the context of the loop itself.
Oh god, nested loops. No. No.
Nested loops are sometimes required.
Yeah, I was gonna say, like, I mean...
Oh, yeah. Sometimes you third, gotta loops. End of the third, baby.
Nice.
The most efficient.
Man. End of the third. Ooh, that's beautiful.
That's gross.
Nice. It is kind of disgusting.
That's the real brute force.
Well, Kenny, I work in a hardware world where I don't...
I mean, you may still have to deal with that, but hopefully...
I don't have to deal with it on a need-to-know basis. I am...
No, you just deal with all of us blaming you.
Ah, fuck!
Shots fired.
There was a forum I used to be on that, like, one of the guy's signatures was stop blaming the hardware, jerks.
Well, I'm PLC hardware, like...
Well, make better hardware, idiot.
You're what?
I guarantee you the PLC code that I blame you guys.
Did I hear PLC as in poor life choices, or what are we talking about? Like, that's the only definition of PLC.
So hi, welcome to the Shmup Book Club featuring programming shit, verbal shit hosting.
That's not even shit posting, but seriously, Team PLC, it's four people.
Actually, now you got me confused about what PLC means. So someone better fucking define it. Okay, thank you.
Oh, okay.
Like, that, like, I don't even deal with it on programming devies. I just pick it out and be contract out to the actual program. I do more process stuff than, like, actual hardware anymore, but...
Do you enjoy doing process stuff?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, there you go.
Wasn't sure if that was, like, by choice or, like, well, someone has to do it.
It's a lot of that going around.
You're the person who's the best at it, even though you hate it.
I'm bad at, like, timing, apparently.
Oh god, this is a lot of chumpos going on.
I missed out on, like, 1,000 points because I timed things poorly. Damn, should just restart now.
Cut your losses.
Alright, right,
it's time to commit really hard to the laser lifestyle.
I mean, that's what I always do that, so...
My only possible play for
coward.
The second boss is have searchers
and
shop twice. Or maybe not use search, because that might actually not be the correct
one. Fuck it, whatever.
Also, I forgot to get speed up, so, well, this is over now.
Oh, that guy's moved on. Very good.
Yep. Dead.
Ultimate power!
Wow!
Oh wow, I did some dodging there, okay!
I mean, that too is a staple of the SBC. What the fuck dodge was this? How did this
some
dodge? Well, no, I was just dancing.
Deal with that.
I was just dancing in between two bullets that I didn't need to.
Oh, well, there goes my dink. Damn, I totally just fucking ran into that.
Wait, I accidentally continued. God damn it.
And that's
why didn't
you
dip push that shit?
That is a dip.
I forgot to.
Well, good job.
Good job.
Now I get to make fun of you for not using options to help make your life easier. Congrats.
I mean, it wasn't even a problem until then. And we've been playing this for a couple of weeks.
Well,
I drove directly into the bullet instead of dodging.
A solid plan.
It's a powerful move.
That's a power play right there. You are showing that bullet who's boss. Spoiler, it's the bullet. It is, in fact, the bullet, not you.
Also, Iron Johnny is doing... I'm doing good, because I just got money back from my mortgage.
Nice.
And I got to buy an arcade stick.
Woo!
Sick.
Do I need to send Zerus over to NAND game? Because that's what you do in NAND
game.
Oh
no!
You build a computer from first principles. Fuck this noise. You have a semiconductor, which if you put a signal in, it reverses it. If you have a signal on both sides, it blocks the signal on the end.
And then you go from there.
I'm doing like a... it's a custom, so I'm doing like an Alpine 6 case. Because everything's Fight 6 now, because Mad Cat is
the tower. What the hell? Might be bankrupt.
Wait, they're bankrupt?
Womp womp.
They're bankrupt they by somebody. No.
Huh.
I don't remember what happened.
Because I thought they... Like, I still remember them making...
Oh
like,
my god, this is a terrible spot to die. Nothing going on.
The, yeah, the stupid's gonna be mostly totally for Muffins and other main jewelry, so...
I'm bad at multiplayer.
Consider. Do better next time. Try hard.
What I need, what I need to do is do the idea that I thought of last time and then promptly forgot about, which is just make a multi-chat.
Ooh.
Yeah, I mean, if you make a multi-chat, I would be interested
I would probably
I would use that.
Yeah,
I mean, I could totally, that should be totally easy.
I mean, I would be able to do it too if I weren't lazy as fuck.
Lazy and also forgetful, so... I mean, like, if I remember to do it, I could probably knock it out in a single, like, train ride.
What am I doing?
It's like an HTML page with a bunch of
chat.
Oh,
yeah,
buttons,
you have
right?
You have train rides and stuff, so you actually have, like...
Free time?
Quote-unquote, idle time, where it's like you have nothing better to do but to do projects like that.
I don't know, I could get behind train.
I mean,
creepy.
That's where I practice speedrunning a lot. On the Vita with RetroArch. I've gone back to Ninja Gaiden 2 now that gotten my goals in Super Metroid for the moment.
You poor thing.
Yeah. Well, it's okay as long as I don't actually have to.
Okay, stage 2 boss now.
I only have to do that for runs.
Good luck.
In the meantime, it is stage 3 boss time for me with its
good luck.
Myriad variety of horrific attacks that I hate.
Yeah, I still have never gotten to stage 3 boss.
Is that wavy purple goo shit? Is that stage 3 boss?
The wavy,
constantly forget about it.
Purple goo shit attack that I hate that I just
got it's not the greatest.
Because I was expecting it to move more to the left, and it sure didn't do that thing that I wanted it to do.
Let's try shot. Oh, this is what shot like looks like fully powered up. Oh, jeez.
I'm the worst at video games, I swear.
That is also terrifying.
You have like five other people vying for that position now. It's a strong contest.
Son of a bitch!
Yeah.
Don't like do it. It's a trap. Don't get into web dev.
No, web dev is the word.
It's not great. It's not
I've managed to position myself out of web dev, and I'm be excited about.
Just learn the flavor of the month JavaScript library and make like really simple portfolio pieces until you get a job in Silicon Valley making $500,000 a year for no reason. That's how that works, right, Kenny?
I can't comment on that because I don't live in Silicon Valley.
Well, I took my bonk.
It is true, though, that some places have learned to not require college for degrees because a lot of people self-teach web development.
Cool. I don't strongly recommend a code boot camp kind of thing unless you already know some programming and are very, very motivated to learn yourself.
Oh,
I can't comment on code boot camps because I've never done them.
I haven't been to one, but I don't need to comment on them.
Yeah, I mean... Part
like
of
half,
it,
half of them are pretty much kind of scummy.
Yeah, they're big scams, mostly.
Part of the problem, too, is, like, even a traditional university is not going to teach you a lot of what you need to survive in a real workplace.
Yeah, so it gets you an initial job because it gives you a degree, and that's basically it. And even then, it's hard, because people are like, we want to see work experience. I'm like, well, I just came out of college, fuck you.
The hot trick is to get an internship and do well enough at they at least hire you full time. And
or
then
in my case, I worked part time on the web team the entire time I was in college.
That's a solid plan too.
That would do it.
But yeah, like all the stuff that I did on the web team, I pretty much didn't learn in my college courses.
Yeah, it's...
Because college scores were just like, Java, 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 and I'm like, thanks, I hate it, and,
stupid ass lasers.
Barf and Java.
I thought he was going to say stupid ass Java, but...
Well,
that's
also true.
There was a bullet there.
There are better decisions you could make for your tech stack than Java.
But anyway, in terms of
I don't know about that.
The problem with web development now is, yeah, there's like the framework of the month club, basically.
Fucking web dev moves at the pace of approximately 5 frameworks a day.
Oh, God.
We're not even joking, that's the best part.
Yeah.
It's not so like
that's honestly legit.
I still managed to enjoy it despite everybody trying to make JavaScript terrible in certain ways.
Having succeeded, in my opinion.
So here's the thing. The ecosystem is kind of terrible, and Webpack is a goddamn monster, and...
Sure is, but it's pretty useful.
It became a monster because people used it for all the wrong reasons originally. Webpack if I understand correctly, Webpack started out basically with a similar goal to Rollup, which is basically bundling JavaScript modules.
Mm-hmm.
But people basically were like, oh, I can use this to do the things that I used Grunt for. I have to, like, you know, hammer it for 5 years until it doesn't resemble itself, but I can do it.
Did you guys stupidly?
I can't tell if you're knowing Kenny's story or
I'm knowing Kenny's story because I know enough.
Yeah, I heard that.
Make it grunt, and I was like, that's terrible, why would you do that?
Yeah, so the problem is, now that everybody has bastardized the crap out of Webpack, now that's Webpack's new goal, is to support all the things that people are incorrectly started using it for. Webpack is basically completely incomprehensible, but other than that, like, honestly, especially if you don't have to worry about Internet Explorer, which, unless you're, like, developing for a large company or government or something, you might not have to anymore.
Hey, I'm in government, and we don't care about Internet Explorer.
Really?
Wow, that's a miracle.
That's great.
You should consider yourself very lucky.
All right.
We have some apps that we still have to run on Internet Explorer, but those are all internal.
Great, so you only subject yourself to...
There are people who do the website on my team that got told they have to support IE11. And code that they wrote isn't supported in IE11, so they have to go and change it.
That sucks.
Thanks, I hate it.
You know what the best part is? It's not my problem.
I don't have
to deal with it.
I don't know where Jerp's coming from with these snobby and elitist. I mean, like, you're gonna find snobby elitist people in any community. I mean, like, hello, look at the Linux user list and
I fucking resemble that. Actually, no, that's not
no,
true.
No, I was pointing at Linus specifically, though. You're not Linus.
Oh, that's true. He's gotten a bit better, though, which is nice.
I will say, from my experience with WebDev, it's not terrible, but WebDev attracts a lot of the tech bros who are assholes.
Sure does.
Yeah, because it's the popular thing nowadays.
I mean, it was popular 10 years ago. The funny thing is, it also attracts people who, like, do a thing and claim they invented it, and actually Dojo did that 15 years ago. Good job, Dev. But, I don't know. I was always... I guess I've never seen software development that I really enjoyed, because, like, I don't know, back in high school I did DB6, obviously.
Well, that's
and then C++, and...
That's a worse time.
I mean, I know C++ has had, like, major developments since then, but I don't know whether that makes it better or worse, or just more confusing.
Yes.
If I were gonna get into software dev now, I would choose to do C#. I have a friend
C# is
that.
Pretty good. I like it.
It's not terrible.
I mean, and now it's real cute because Java's trying to play catch-up with C#. It's like, yeah, that's cute, but you're still doing it wrong, and it's terrible.
Hey, man, TypeScript is a fucking godsend for JavaScript, alright?
I was gonna say, like, that
TypeScript pretty okay.
is actually adopting things that C# has, and
yeah.
TypeScript has been earlier.
TypeScript
like,
is okay, but TypeScript is also annoying because the tool chain to make TypeScript actually fit into all the rest of the shit is just as bad as everything else in JavaScript.
Yeah,
which
it's very hard to integrate, surely. You're not wrong.
Yeah.
But the ideas behind TypeScript are at least sort of okay. Like,
let's make JavaScript not terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, like, there are times where it kind of there are times, at least early on, when I felt like it would get in your way of, like, actually making use of features of JavaScript, but they have made it increasingly, like, more flexible, and my team just converted it, their entire code base to TypeScript this
quarter. That's an undertaking.
And it actually, like, I mean, there were some snags, but it actually went pretty well. And yeah, it's really, like, I finally started using Visual Studio Code.
I love Code, actually.
Surprisingly good tool.
So I originally tried it and hated it because their idea of how to handle open files and switching between them was, like, bonkers. Now they actually support that. Like, I can actually configure it to do what I want, which is switch tabs in the order that they appear. Who would want to do that, right?
That's completely unreasonable.
Okay, here's the TLDR. If you want to get into web dev, but you don't have a college degree and you don't want to go to college, come up with a project that sounds cool that you think you can probably do and just fucking make it on the web.
Yeah.
That's called making a portfolio. And if you can fucking, like, organize your own goddamn project and make it work,
yeah,
you can probably get hired anywhere.
Yeah.
And maybe, like, well, so there's... There was a book, like, years and years ago that I heard people recommend if you're, like, totally new to JavaScript called Eloquent JavaScript, and I think that's still a thing. I'm not sure how up-to-date it is for, like, ES6, if it is at all. There's also, I think Nicholas Zakas has a LeanPub book called Understanding ES6, or Understanding ECMAScript 6, I have read that. And Mozilla Developer Network is always a good reference tool in general.
Right. Although, the problem with a lot of those reference tools is you have to know enough about what you're doing to know what you're looking for.
True. Right. No, so that's why I'm trying to point out, like, the other, like, things to actually, like, read to get a more holistic idea first.
CanIUse.com is also quite useful.
CanIUse! God damn. The number of times I had to check that when I was in consultancy.
Oh,
sure
no. Yeah.
But yeah, I will definitely admit...
7.
I will definitely admit that I'm one of the people who... And I mean, like, this is why, like, stuff like Electron ends up motivating people, too, is, like, people who are front-end developers want to, like, use the languages that they know, and so they use JavaScript for scripting, because you can use Node.js for basically shell scripting, too.
I still... I have... Let's not put a quarter in the Node train, because that's... nothing good comes from a discussion about Node. Nothing. Nothing at all.
And I have... no context of any of this.
Node is basically a platform to let you run JavaScript on, like, on the server on the back end. It's
there.
It exists. I don't know. I kind of like it, but I'm probably in the minority, so whatever.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what makes it terrible.
The ecosystem mostly.
Okay. I said that part before.
Oh, what happened to my shield, you fucks?
Damn it. But, like.
Sorry, continue?
I feel like no matter what programming language you're using, there's gonna be things that are terrible.
Well, because people are involved with anything programming, and people are terrible.
People are terrible.
So, like, I don't mean,
like,
this to dissuade people from getting into
anybody.
Web development.
Fuck! I meant to tap left, but I just went further up instead. I'm the worst.
I feel like, generally, at the very least, you get to spend less time dealing with browser idiosyncrasies now than you did, you know, 10 years ago.
Yeah, that's because we're going to a new monoculture, though, which is also not the best.
Oh, don't get me started on fucking Chromium.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, come on. Let's be fair. Firefox exists.
It does, and it's much better than it has been.
Yeah, you know what existed back in the IE days? Other browsers, but nobody used them.
I think I used Netscape.
Yeah.
Netscape.
Like,
here's the reality.
Browsers back in the IE6 days. Oh. That was probably when, like, Firefox was still Phoenix.
Here's the reality. No one wants to fucking keep up on all the changes to HTML they keep rolling out. Writing your own fucking rendering engine is terrible.
I mean, really, they should maybe just fucking cool their jets on changing literally everything about the web every 45 seconds.
Nah. That wouldn't be hip and disruptive.
Maybe if they fucking slowed their roll for a goddamn year or so, things would actually be allowed to stabilize.
Finally got past that stupid part. For some reason, I was walled on. Yeah, I was walled on.
I'm so worked up by all of this, I'm dying now.
Oh, sure. Blame you being worked up about dumb web standards.
Dumb!
Wow!
There's the fucking one! I died again!
Way to go, see? No one to blame but yourself.
Alright, well, my jokes didn't do it this time. I don't know.
This is why I don't work in web, and I'm real glad.
My dog is extremely concerned about y'all. Either that or she wants attention. It's hard to say.
Sorry.
Meanwhile, people from chat who just got over here from OS from Magic are really confused. It's like, I thought this was schmobs. What is all this about? No.
Alright, there we go.
We're talking about our day jobs.
There we go. That's the best name I could have come up with. Fuck JS.
Come on. There's probably a library called that by now.
I guarantee you.
I know that there's a fuck it JS. Which makes
that sounds vaguely familiar, actually.
Yeah, it makes your web shit work. Fuck it JS makes your web shit work by just randomly deleting files until it doesn't run into an error.
That's fair.
That seems like
The best way to handle that situation, honestly.
That works. That'll fix your JavaScript.
I mean, I would have liked to do that with customers' code at my previous job.
Why are your customers writing code?
That's a good question. They definitely shouldn't be.
Like, if they're paying you, why are they writing code? These are the questions we ask.
Yeah. That's even worse than a VP of engineering writing code.
Oh.
That was a dodge.
That could be good or bad.
No, it's very bad.
Oh,
weren't they supposedly
about
engineers once, or no?
Supposedly, yeah.
How long ago?
But, decades.
Oh, that's a problem then.
Yeah.
Oh god, I'm doing stupid things. How did I not die? Holy shit.
Maybe they should consider doing their actual job of, like, high-level shit.
I won't deny, SteveHax, that Node is pretty solid. I just like to bitch about it.
Everybody well, I mean, does. Like, if you're bitching about the ecosystem, I will completely relate on that.
Like, see, Node itself isn't bad. There's a lot of baggage that comes in with using Node, because the ecosystem.
Because it falls under the rest of basically your one-size-fits-all JavaScript ecosystem problems.
The thing that the one thing that irritated me was when jQuery gave up on their own plugin repository, so they just said use Node to install everything, and I'm like, Node is NPM.
Oh, okay.
And like that was when NPM started touting itself as the package manager for not just Node but also browsers and stuff. But that's not really the full story. How am I not dead? Seriously.
A lot of interesting
like,
sidebars.
I'm gonna have to highlight this just because, like, Kenny manages to miraculously dodge shit while talking about dumb crap.
Hey, Megalodon.
The opposite
that's
of me.
A clip title. That's a clip title.
I died three times in a row for
I don't
being
think that'll fit. Also, it probably
crap.
Won't let me do that because it has a curse word in it, but anyway.
The subtitle for the Best of Shmup Book Club.
I mean, somebody really ought to go through and, like, do a Best of Shmup Book Club, because
oh,
I'm sure
that would take forever to go through.
Man, I ain't got, like, 30 billion hours to spare? Come on.
That's a lot of footage to watch, yo.
I feel like you could probably just skim through and find some good stuff. Even if it's not all of the best of, you could probably find some good uns.
I'd probably just look at the waveform and see where
it
peaks.
Oh, I should have done search.
The burst of Shmup Book Club is like everyone getting Wilson turreted or like getting sniped with one bullet.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or that tank you thought you passed in Raiden like shooting right before it falls off the screen.
Oh, fuck Raiden tanks.
Alright, I guess
I'm gonna
mess
with
this. What happened?
Guy.
Holy, what? I don't remember those things shooting.
What?
Oops, I accidentally got a shield when I wanted power.
Well. Gotta live with it, I guess.
I mean, that's not.
This is some rank that's happening, I think.
Have fun with that rank over there, Kenny?
SteveHax. I feel like you are. That's got to be a nightmare situation. I'm here at work, and all of a sudden people are talking about work things while I'm just trying to watch a stream to not think about work.
We're sorry, okay?
Also, now I forgot the speed pickup again.
Well.
That's okay. Once I die, this is pretty much over anyway, because second boss with no power-ups is, like,
the worst.
Yeah, it's not great. At least you don't have
actually,
rank to deal with.
I like how that one ship was up and just dive-bombed me.
That was some bullet lead, and I was kind of proud of that.
Hey, Hey, pro player. Doing pro player shit with that bullet leading and dodging bullets and not running into things and stuff.
What are you doing in the Shmup Book Club? What the hell?
I wish I could be a pro player like that someday.
It's okay, I immediately died to the first two turnaround laser guys.
Alright, fair, you're back
in. The first
ass laser dudes, right?
They fly on screen, they shoot normal bolts, and then they flip around and shoot lasers up their ass.
Yeah, that's the ones that Bond is always talking about.
Dumbass lasers. The dumbass ass lasers.
The dumbass ass lasers.
Ass lasers.
This would work better. That was interesting. I dodged a bullet that looked like I shouldn't have.
That saying you have a job in JavaScript infrastructure just sounds like a terrible life.
Oh, that does. Yeah, I don't envy that. Sorry.
I hope you get paid lots of money for that, because that sounds like a job no one wants.
Wait, what are we talking about?
JavaScript infrastructure as a job.
Sounds like there would be a lot of problems
to
solve.
What kind of infrastructure?
So it might be interesting. Something.
Let's see that life story up here.
Oh, did I skip him? Well, oh, what? Oh, it says doing JS infrastructure. I missed that part. Okay.
It's okay. I can read chat.
We pay good attention
like
here.
What else did I miss?
No, I'm just really good at looking over.
I have way too many screens to look over to, so it's tough to catch too much in chat, especially while I'm, you know, trying not to do that thing where I run into, like, bullets.
I'm also in stage one, so I can pretty much sleep through it.
I just noticed that when it goes into the demo and it closes the thing, it says demonstration with an exclamation mark.
Yeah, it's one hell of a demo, though.
Here's
how
it's
back
excited.
Into bullets.
That's good. I needed the visual demonstration on how to back into bullets, because I'm not sure I would have figured it out on my own.
It's a fucking pro strat, you know? They gotta
Today,
highlight
we
that
will
shit.
Learn how not to back into bullets.
Don't watch me, then. Consider any other source of knowledge for that knowledge, because, I'm not going to be able to help you there.
Perfect.
Oh. But yeah, so despite everybody's complaints about web dev, for some reason I still choose to do it.
As do I. Because
I still think it's cool, even though they try to make it not cool sometimes.
Except for CSS. CSS isn't cool.
CSS is
the
worst.
Yeah, SCSS is better, though.
Zerst, that's lame, though. You should be on the call and verbally shitposting with the rest of us, jeez.
Unless you're at work, in which case I guess you should do your work instead of watching us.
Yeah.
Or don't, I mean, whatever, it's probably fine.
Your job, if your bosses are okay with it, I don't care.
Unfortunately, Twitch is blocked at my work, so even though my bosses would be cool with it, I literally can't.
No, knowing where you work, that entirely makes sense, though.
Yeah, no,
I'm not
a larger company,
bad.
So.
I'm just saying that, like, working in CSS sucks.
So
I think CSS itself is pretty good at this point.
I work in a library that makes heavy use of like SAS mixins and stuff, so I still feel like it's not. But
I mean,
it's
if you want SAS, SAS is fine.
What surprises me is the number of people. Okay, this is going back into JavaScript ecosystem bullshit. The number of people who will vehemently like rail against SAS because it's not CSS and JS or post CSS or whatever, and then I go look at post CSS to see what all the hubbub is about, and I see a bunch of plugins basically replicating SAS, and I'm like, why? that's like people who insist that, you know. 10 years ago, who insisted on using jQuery and then cobbling together a bunch of other random crap when they realized it wasn't enough for their job, instead of using something more holistically complete like Adobe.
But jQuery!
I died stupidly because I was yelling jQuery.
That would be one hell of a tombstone.
jQuery. I ran into this bullet because I was talking about jQuery.
And like, I mean, jQuery itself,
ages.
Nothing against jQuery itself, it's just it does, you know, a certain set of things and it's not the be-all end-all.
jQuery was really cool before there was a way to like pick things by DOM stuff.
Yeah, and then remember there was the whole CSS and like selector edge
Are you okay with that, Zachy?
I think that was Mr. Bond.
No, it surely wasn't.
No,
I
some
was
of that
quiet.
Was definitely Zachy.
You did not hear a loud squawk. That was not me.
That is true.
And it wasn't ass something or other.
Yeah.
So.
Something with ass.
It was trying to weave through bullets to get to a shield. It got off to give me a shield, and I failed.
Honk.
I think I'm going to be done for tonight because I've been streaming for an hour and I'm just doing stupid things now.
Okay.
That's all my fault for bringing up. No, wait, I didn't technically bring up JavaScript, but I kept talking about it.
But I did at least get a new high score at the beginning. So.
Where did JavaScript get brought up?
I have no clue.
Someone's interested in web dev.
I'm not blaming others, because hey, web development is something that I'm into too, so I'm totally happy to talk about it.
Web development is something I'm perfectly happy to let other people do.
Okay, so I'm just going to stop
my like model view controller.
Eh?
Microsoft model view controller.
MVC,
yeah. Sorry.
Well, I'm going to stop my stream, but I'll still probably just stay on the call. So.
Alright.
You know what I should maybe get, but I haven't gotten yet? A speed up.
Oh.
yeah,
those.
Nah, are you don't need
kind
those.
Of important.
I'm kind of seeing how. Oh, I drove into a laser.
well, there you go.
Alright.
Perfect.
I don't know if having speed up would have really helped with that, other than letting you drive into it faster.
I backed off the brake into the laser. Alright, I'm gonna step away and grab a beverage. I'm actually gonna play some other shit.
Oh no.
Betrayal!
A little bit of front end web stuff. Pure pass to do, at least he can avoid jQuery because people overuse it for the simple shit. Do people really still overuse it in 2019? Because, like, most of the stuff that you would have used jQuery for, you don't need it for anymore. Like, query selector all is a thing. Fetch is a thing.
Yeah.
Promises are a
thing.
Hey,
people are bad at writing code.
Yeah.
You write what you know.
Basically everything else.
I vaguely recall, like, randomly going to Stack Overflow a year or two ago and still seeing people, like, answering and asking jQuery.
Oh, there are
and
still
like,
tons
this is
of
still
those
a thing?
There.
Wow,
yeah,
it's
absolutely.
Like,
yeah,
must be cool to be able to just like write web code in a bubble, completely protected from all the insane crap that's going on now in the JavaScript ecosystem. You're still using jQuery.
I don't know if that's a benefit. I really don't.
That was dumb.
I mean, you don't have to use Webpack, so there's that.
Yeah.
Well, I mean,
seems like
yeah,
a price I'd
okay.
rather pay though.
Down.
Let's see, my new high score is about 1,000 more than my old high score. Or maybe it's 10,000.
It's something!
Oh, yeah, you also have classless, so you don't need jQuery for that.
Oh.
Are you still talking about JavaScript, Kenny?
Yes, yes they are.
Come
on,
my god.
It's like 20 seconds of dead silence and then class lists come up. Son of a bitch! Go on.
Alright, so let's find something
good.
New to rant about collectively as a group then. What other things have been pissing everyone in the call off lately? Because apparently there's plenty. Apparently there's a ton. Alright, very good. Everyone's happy.
It's just the
until the next
script that gets to us, apparently.
That's bad. Can't be good. Oh! Okay, I zoned out.
Consider. Do not that thing.
Yeah, probably isn't a great idea when 20 enemies are on screen all shooting bullets at once.
And you're just like.
Like, I'm in a safe place? Not really.
I appreciate us going through the fucking just playlist of random garbage now.
Oh, Oh, wow, that was 1,800 points away from
18 wheeler.
Actually, getting a better score than I've got so far. That's interesting. Ow.
Magic.
Actually, I think I'm gonna get off, so I'll talk to you guys later.
Alright, take care, Cartron.
See ya.
Take it easy. Oops.
Well, that was dumb. That wasn't even the thing I wanted. Oh, god damn it. I ended up getting missile instead of search, and I also lost my shield at the same time.
Rip.
Sounds
and,
like
my shirt broke down, and my girlfriend ran away, and,
Wow, what a downer.
You don't have nearly enough twang going on in the background and say things like that. Come on, you gotta up that twang.
Yeah, that's right.
That drawl.
And I didn't get the correct number of points.
I've heard that game, I have
twice picked up power-ups right before using the thing, and I end up using the wrong thing. Okay, I'm gonna reset and catch up my chat.
Jerp, yeah, it seems like game dev is a fucking hell to work for, unfortunately.
When I was a kid, I always wanted to think about getting into game dev, and then I took an OpenGL course in college and was like, wow, this is ridiculous. And then also I found out what a shit show game dev shops actually work.
Yeah.
So,
for infinite hours.
Yeah, I get to work like 40 hours a week. It's pretty cool.
Yeah,
I appreciate that a bunch. You know what's
honestly,
nice?
I'm kind of doubting myself right now because, like, for the past 2.5 years, I have also been doing that. To be fair, my job before this one, I also don't think I ever really had to do any kind of overtime. But I am actually, today I actually just gave notice, and I am joining a new company.
Oh, shit. Congrats.
In a few weeks. And I may end up, like, there may actually be crunch times. Like, it sounds like it's probably not often, but I don't know. We'll find out.
I'm gonna play some guitar.
Got it. People there seem
good
pretty
luck.
Chill overall.
I played some Futari. It's
Futari is a difficult
it's
but
a game.
Fun game.
It's a very game. Because original is like, hey, we heard you like Toadplay and shooting, but thought they were too easy.
I mean, basically, yeah.
How about we heard you like Toadplay shooters, but didn't like actually being able to like, count your points?
No, that's,
That's Gigawang. That's Gigawang straight up.
Oh, that's true.
That's Takumi in a nutshell is, hi, I heard you didn't want to have any concept of what your score actually is.
Also, fair warning, we may get some Bork in here. Doggo is up and about.
Oh my.
Although I just saw the light, so maybe not.
Doggo Borkin. Gonna feel like a Metroid hack stream then. With Doggo Borkin. Alright! Not actually sure what bullet I ran into there. And, Jerp, honestly, like, if you have decent people to work with, that makes a huge difference.
Yeah. And, like, I've been pretty lucky about that in at least my last two jobs. Arguably all three, but... Like, three full-time companies I've worked for.
Right. Granted, you have to still balance that with maybe having some free time to do stuff is also important. But if you had to pick between 40 hours of work with good... or with shitty people and 50 hours of work with good people... It might at least lean towards the latter, depending on your state of affairs. Because, like, the good people will help make those 50 hours not shitty.
Yeah. Interesting. I just realized that, like, how... Well, I guess these count as separate bullets or something that I'm shooting? I don't know. Just, like, things
well,
could die quicker Atari, if I hit them smack with everything versus if I hit them from the side. Wow, I didn't dodge that correctly. Well...
Alright, well, I died near the end of... Well, I died multiple times in stage 3, but I took a death near the end of it again, which means that it's that magical zone of, like, everything is terrible and you're not going to be able to get anything to actually, like...
Make it not
get
terrible.
Get your feet under you again, yeah.
Yeah, this kind of a little too much of the radius effect.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. Oh, that's speed level 3. I've made a terrible mistake.
RIP.
I was not
paying
attention.
Speed level honk.
Speed level fuck my life. Speed level faster than desired.
That was dumb. I went right back into that bullet. I was like, no, you know what? Hold on. I want to be your friend.
Wait a minute.
Make
let's go in for a closer look.
Bullet.
And then I just, yeah, okay. I don't think I'm getting anywhere in that.
Okay, I made a kind of impressive dodge in Katari, and I'm kind of proud of myself.
Oh. Sir.
Oh, Frank.
Would you die, please? Thank you.
Missile!
Oi.
Missile.
Oi, oi, oi.
M-I-S-S.
I-S-S-I-L-L-E.
M-I-S-S-L-E. Missile. There's only 6 characters to work with. The fuck you want from me?
M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-L-L-E.
Wait a minute.
Hold on a second. Like spelling banana.
Is that some sort of like alligator missile or something?
Oh shit, what did I, shit,
banana
I hope that was
banana
yeah.
Banana nanners.
What am I doing? That was dumb.
I think I
what are any of us doing right now?
Damn it.
Well, I'm finishing my beer, and then I'm probably grabbing another beer so that I play better.
Strong play.
Yeah, I feel like I should actually have a drink tonight, but
something's on
the bottom of me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 2, I mean, what?
That is the wrong community.
That was a bullet down there that I didn't
notice.
It's
the wrong community for that.
Maybe I should use my bombs. That would be a nice thing to do.
There we go.
How does one join the SBC? You go to EI's stream and find his Discord link and join that, and then wake up
then,
in the SBC
and
channel.
Then post right. Scores and stuff.
Yeah.
You do not need to be on the stream to participate, but joining the
that's
stream
cool
to make
too.
The... Joining the stream to make and call to make it even more raucous bullshit is hardly the worst thing in the world.
I was gonna say join the stream to make the pain go away.
No, you drink to make the pain go away.
I mean, a little
hell calming. On the wrong side. Whoop. Okay. Crisis averted. Didn't hit the bomb.
Sounds good, Zerst. Are you gonna pop in the call as well? I might, like, sweet. Verbal shit posting!
Azur's gonna make us all look bad.
Yeah, oh, absolutely. There's like.
10 minutes.
There's a whole bunch of like the actual shmuppers that have joined the SBC that are just showing all of us chumpos up.
Yeah, we're starting to get people who are really good at shmups, oh my gosh.
Like, we've got like 3 strata of shmuppers now. You've got like the shmupper beginners that are learning, doing good, and like picking up the stuff. You've got like the mid-tier folks like me and Bond who are like, yeah, we can kind of shmup, I guess.
Damn,
sort
that's
of.
Generous for me.
And then we've got the top-tier people like Icarus. You're just like,
and then you've got the specialists like me and Zaki who get really high scores on specific games.
And are like mid-tier otherwise, probably, yeah.
And then I got dunked immediately in stage 3. Beautiful.
Pro.
Strong
not
play.
Bad for
you know.
I mean, honestly, though, I love
dang
that
it,
we
I
have...
got laser.
Damn. I love that we have those levels of people, though, because we've got, like, people have reasonable competition no matter what their skill level, and I feel like that's really cool. Because, like, me and Bond are going back and forth on most months, and, like, Firetron and Cows are close matches for each other on most months, and then Icarus can dunk everybody, but then sometimes Pearl shows up like, "Hi, what's up? I can play too."
and then sometimes people kill 30 million goddamn turtles.
Oh, the turtles.
But okay, now to play a game with only two buttons. It's time to play Pink Sweets, because let's just keep playing questionable cage muffs.
Are you calling Futari a questionable cave shmup? Because I'm kind of going to disagree with you there.
It's not.
Two buttons, yeah.
Fuck!
Jeez. V5's so good, it doesn't even need a bomb.
True enough.
Unless you're playing Grindstormer, in which case...
That's
then
not
gets
V5.
A... Well, okay, fair point. Aw, damn, that turret shot me before the power-up ship crashed into me.
Damn.
Pink Sweets has some sort of bullet canceling or shield that I don't fucking understand.
Alright, I'm gonna take a momentary break here.
No, you coward, get back here!
No! I'm making everything up as I go.
That's the way to do it. Freestyle lifestyle.
Freestyle No, that's also a different thing.
That's a joke.
Oh!
You suck, McBain.
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Citation needed based
Doing
on the tone
acceptable.
Oh, yeah. You know what? The funniest thing happened at work today. Somebody randomly asked me... They basically pulled a citation needed for me to verify that Wikipedia wasn't talking out its ass about the origin of the word emoji.
Wait, what?
Did you just go to Wikipedia's citation?
They apparently had typed it into Google Translate and gotten something completely different and were suspecting it. And so I'm like, all right, I'm going to go look up the parts on gshow.org. And yep, it checks out. And then I put the kanji into Google Translate and it checks out. So.
What a weird thing. But okay.
Yeah. Seemed awfully random, because, like, I don't even know what that was related to. Can't imagine that was related to work, but maybe it was, but I'm very, very curious about that now.
Who
knows? Almost went double.
What? This outfit is so questionable, I don't even understand. Oh, is there, like, a charge mechanic? Oh, I didn't even know that.
Charge mechanics.
Yeah, if you let off the, it's like back raid.
Okay, so it's
no.
Yeah.
Let's not die to
back
that.
Rider, back rider.
Let's not die to that either.
Rider, not back rider. What the fuck?
I mean, I'd play back rider. Back rider.
Back rider. All right, Rising. Damn.
Okay. Third boss down.
Oh no, must scratch eye.
Also,
don't shoot at me.
Hello, Anonymous.
Okay, thank you.
Don't shoot.
Sorry, only had a chance to look in chat now.
Don't shoot at me, scratching eyes.
Ah!
That level 3 speed, did I fuck it up again? This feels too fast. I probably fucked it up again.
What?
Womp womp.
I'm not sure what I'm doing.
Oh no, that was- no, it was only level 2! Ah, fucker! Alright, fuck it. Let's just like this run.
Let's restart it. Don't worry about it.
Okay, I know on some level I have angered the rank gods, because now there's suddenly a lot more bullets.
Alright, maybe I'll quick redo the multi-link. That's something productive I can do, right? I'll redo the multi-link to put Xerxes on there.
I died because I don't remember which button 2 in my setup now. Aw,
that's a lot of bullets. And that
that's
is a ship.
Strong.
Whoa, that's some lag. Interesting.
This is not a smart idea.
Destroy the big pearly mid boss in stage 2 with Surge and,
Yeah, that wasn't a smart idea.
Okay, Kao's not. Firetron has stopped. Everyone else is still active. Zerst, are you just... Yeah, you're just Zerst. Okay, very good. Multi-link should be updated, but it'll probably take a few to have it actually reflect that.
Oh,
also, Zerst, they see you in the call, but you are not making noise, for whatever that's worth, I guess.
Yeah, I'm just not saying anything.
Oh,
hello.
Well, okay then.
You are correct that I am in the call and not making noise. Good observation.
The multi appears to be up to date, so there you go.
Also, I'm not used to streaming with Discord. Does it pipe my audio input through my stream?
It depends on where your audio is going.
I mean, if your mic is... Are you talking about your own mic or Discord stuff or what?
Yeah, just my own mic.
That depends on you having an audio input for your mic and OBS.
Which, if you stream with your own mic, is probably true. Probably
right, but what I'm asking is if Discord itself pipes it through.
Discord will pipe it to whatever audio device you have it set up for. So if you have an input for that, then you're good.
Yeah, like if Discord's going through the same audio device that...
Like your game audio
the game
is
going through, then...
Sure, I just don't know if I need to mute my microphone in OBS.
Oh.
You
shouldn't. You shouldn't. God damn it, that was dumb. I was actually set up for that boss properly, and now this is terrible. That was like the one time I got to the second boss with proper equipment.
Everything is awful!
God damn it, no.
Everything is shitty when you're all alone!
No. No. God damn it.
I'm kind of amused at how offended you are by this.
That was a strong reaction to my
volunteer. Yeah, it's almost like we started talking about JavaScript again. Holy shit.
Kenny,
because
stop.
I volunteered for robotics for a while. I did Lego stuff. And so, every fucking group of kids is like, everything is awesome.
Yeah, but it's not everything is awesome, it's everything is awful.
Yes, you must correct
conceptually,
them.
Conceptually still the same. Same tune. Sorry, I'm catching mans.
I died to the
first. Oh my.
Because they're playing.
Are you catching
Fever
the fever?
Yes, I'm catching the fever. Yes!
That's a game that somebody ought to submit for a poll one of these times. Because that's.
What's the guys to run Mushi Mushi Pork? That'll be a game. That'll be a month. I don't know why
what
I drove into bullets. Like, I knew there were bullets there and I drove into them.
I mean, you were being neighborly. It's nothing to be ashamed of.
Alright,
yeah,
I might
be extremely bad at Fever on right now.
I might need to switch the game I'm playing, because I'm just being increasingly the worst.
Yeah, I'm wondering whether I should even bother trying Crimson Clover tonight.
I can't be bothered to, reboot my machine to make it run at an acceptable frame rate.
I'm still... curious how I haven't had that problem since switching it to full screen.
That is a
I don't know. I've had that problem both ways on my current machine, and I just gave up on trying to fix it. Sure, we can play some. We can play some Kate Swee.
You got your PS4 set up?
No. That's effort.
God damn it.
Yeah, I still haven't rehooked up my PS4 yet, but I mean, I
I'm
only
already
have
one
for it right now anyway.
The PS4 is still, in fact, in a bin. It's not even accessible. I'd have to unpack it. And I don't even know offhand which bin it is, so I'd have to spend time figuring that out.
Sounds like a lot of work.
Which is something I need to do before Sunday, but is not something that's probably going to happen before Sunday. Unless I, at some point, tomorrow night if I get back early from old work happy hour. Because apparently all of that's just fucking happening this week is just all the happy hours ever.
Old work? Wait, yeah, there's a distinction
coworkers,
now?
Coworkers from my previous work have invited me to a happy hour for previous work.
That's interesting. That's a heck of a coincidence.
Eh, free booze is free booze.
I mean, I'll probably end up having to mostly buy my booze because I'm like, boo, you know, no longer affiliated with them or anything.
Oops. You're a scab.
But,
So, I mean, is this all just like end of quarter launch shit or what?
No, it's just like happy hours happen to be scheduled at the same point in time, and they're just sort of periodic happy hours that happen to be on the same week.
Oh.
Yeah. I know, it's totally coincidence. I thought those had stopped firing, but they didn't, and I'm still the worst. But yeah, Beauty, I am aware that we are still ace combating on Sunday, and I need to set up a whole bunch of things for that stream between now and then. Don't worry. It's on my radar. Don't have to worry about it.
I just like to complain, you know that. We've established my need to complain about things.
We've established everybody's need to complain about certain things.
That sounded like another JavaScript segue.
I don't know. I
was not gonna say the word.
I was like, let's not start this back up.
I'm just like, one regular person in my chat decides to bring that up on the Night of Shmup Book Club, and everybody has opinions on it that generally are not agreeable with my own, or only halfway agreeable, because like I still do it anyway.
What does that say about you?
It says I prefer to tolerate the pain of JavaScript than the pain of other things that aren't JavaScript.
That's a fair assessment.
Just learn Haskell.
All right, that's fair.
Just learn Haskell.
Oh, good God.
Where are you going to get a job writing Haskell?
You won't. That's the fun part.
I think we have very different definitions of fun. All
right, I'm totally going to play, like, Blue Revolver normal mode instead.
Haskell is not a language you learn because you want to do something useful with it.
It's a language
that you don't have time for code golf bullshit. I have no appreciation for that.
Bullshit. It's a language you learn when you want to like write arrows and shit and write incomprehensible letters, and then everything works and no one knows why.
As fun as that sounds, I'm gonna have
I can't
to pass.
Curl.
Pearl's I mean, also... Perl is a write-only language.
Perl is that, but different.
I'm so Pearl glad is... we have multiple variations of it.
Perl is that, but different. Lisp is that, but parentheses.
Lisp is you move a parenthesis and suddenly your program nukes the world.
Yeah, is there a fucking Lisp library that just like randomly deletes parentheses?
Oh my god, that would be great.
Probably. It's probably written in Lisp.
It's written in Perl just to fuck with people.
You know, that sounds about right.
Actually, no, it's written in Brainfuck. Let's be really honest
here.
It's really hard to write anything useful in Brainfuck.
Correct. Actually, it's hard to even write, like, just dumb little pet programs in Brainfuck, let's be honest.
It's hard to write anything meaningful in Brainfuck, yes.
I don't even think you have to use the word meaningful there.
Yeah, it's a superfluous objective, but, you know,
it took
whatever.
Like 7 years for them to figure out how to write Hello World in Brainfuck. Which I find delightful.
Really?
Someone basically reverse engineered how the language worked to figure out how to write Hello World in it.
I feel like that's beautiful and exactly what I would expect out of a language called Brainfuck. Just saying.
Or is that Mel Bulge? I can't remember. One of them is useful and one of them is like literally impossible to program in. But it's still Turing complete.
Technically.
Ah yes, the best kind of Turing completes.
I'm delighted that we have a call sufficiently full of people who are in the biz, so to speak, so we can all, like... I'm just gonna restart that entire thing.
Oh, no!
That's fucking embarrassing.
Now that was Mr. Bond.
Yes, that was me. Welcome. You must be new here. Son of a bitch!
Wow, you get out on the movies.
Asshole, whatever these things are.
Asshole, whatever these things are. That's right, you heard me. I was there. Alright, I thought I was slightly to the left of that. I did not dodge that properly. All right. Now everything is terrible again.
I shouldn't give up on shmups. I just need to figure out what to play instead. Because I don't feel like stopping streaming. But shmupping is clearly... I'm clearly past my prime on shmupping for today.
Oh yeah, has anybody else checked out the OC Remix Chrono Cross album yet?
That's
right there.
On the list again.
How did I not get hit by that bullet?
I just listened to most of the first disc, first folder, I guess, tonight on the train. Honestly, I think I'm too attached to the soundtrack itself to really, like, be able to respect remixes that do, like, weird stuff with it, but...
Here's my thing on OC Remix. There's some really interesting creative people on OC Remix, but there are a lot of people who are completely right on the stream.
Why is that still there?
Well,
get out of here, Crab Doge. So here's the thing. Like,
I remember when I listened to Project Chaos, I thought basically almost every song was interesting and cool.
See, I listened to the Final Fantasy VII album, so I have my bar is low.
But for the Chrono Cross one, I feel like some things are just like I thought that OC Remix generally had a pretty high bar for things, and I feel like I was mistaken about how high the bar was.
What is happening to my stream right now?
Which is not to say that they're bad.
OC Remix has reviewers, and the reviewers have opinions about the rules, and some of them are really bad.
Yeah, because like I feel like. So, like, there's one song in the, actually, there's one song that's at both the beginning and the end of the first, folder in it. That one has vocals and one doesn't. I objectively like the one that doesn't better, because I think the vocals are, like, they're okay, but I feel like they don't add enough to the song. But then, like, the stuff that it's doing, it's a remix of basically, like, the Radical Dreamer song that you hear at the end of the game. And, like, I like some of the things that it tries to do, I feel like it doesn't mix some of them well.
Questionable mixing and mastering is, like, a hallmark of those remix.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Somebody pick a direction, please.
You're doing that.
I couldn't come up with anything better, and it's totally easy for me to just play easy mode on this and just kick back and not give a shit, so I'm doing that.
And 500 rooms later, you realize you should have gone to bed an hour ago.
Well, yeah, I'm
classic.
That's why I'm starting an easy run now, and if it's like an hour from now, I'll stop playing easy. Because then I don't have to worry about that issue, because it'll get too hard for me to actually survive.
Oh, that was dumb.
Yeah, there were two songs that stood out to me on the first album. One is, there's a remix of Forest of Cutting Shadows that I think stays true enough to the original and also has like a vibe to it that like really works, that just seemed really cool, and that's one of my favorite songs. Like, that was one of the first songs that really stuck out to me when I played the game. And then there's a remix of Star Stealing Girl, which is redone as like super chill jazz type stuff, which I was like, I'm going to hate this. Why don't I hate this? This is actually anime as fuck and it's pretty awesome.
Well, there's your answer.
Like, you could totally, like, picture this behind, like, Samurai Champloo or something.
I'm gonna cut my stream, but I'm gonna hang in the call. I think I'm gonna play some Monster Hunter.
Alright. Good luck, have fun, Beauty.
I'm staying on the call, that's what I was saying.
Well, good luck, have fun with hunting monsters.
Oh, yes.
Don't let them punch you in the face, that's bad.
Well,
they don't really settle for punching, usually.
Don't let them claw you in the face. Fucking whatever, man. Don't let them do whatever thing they do that causes harm to your face.
Don't let them turn your face into a new zip code.
It's okay, I have a shield.
Okay.
Okay, so you can suffer one day.
I'll just believe you on that. I don't, I'm not sure.
No, I play Gunlance. Gunlance and Lance can block like literally everything. They're like 6 or 7 players in the game with that special skill. And I know where all those things are.
So I did not press start.
Not to hit.
Why did it pause?
The game disagrees.
Well, clearly, but like. My hand is nowhere near the goddamn start button, and all of a sudden, stupid thing pauses.
Also, Monster Hunter World's PC is implementing the best feature, having a level of privacy between no one can join and everyone can join.
Friends can join?
Yes.
Wow.
It only took them like a year after release.
Also, Kenny, speaking of all this crab doging, I never ended up with the goddamn grapple.
Grapple?
538
wow.
rooms and 0 grapple.
Oh yeah, you that's, better.
To be fair, you were avoiding left entrances for a while.
I wasn't though, and there was a point in time where it was like, there was somewhere in like the 200 to 300s where I was starting to try and do left entrances to get the grapple, or see if it could happen, and it never did. And at some point, it flipped to I'd be disappointed if I found it now, because it would ruin.
Yogi Nani, I like it.
You better find a seed with early grapple then, just in case that thingy didn't get smacked.
Yeah, that work has already been done.
Ah, very good.
Wait, what are we talking about? Wait, what do we need early grapple for? Oh, right.
Witches.
For dumb out-of-bounds glitch bullshit, which is really funny, and I love doing it, because it's dumb.
Are we talking about the soft block, basically, or something else?
I would say it's even more than the soft block, because, like, I think the only thing that keeps going is the music.
Okay, that's more severe than I just remember you getting like, stuck in the floor in Bomb Teresa's room.
If you get sufficiently out of bounds, the game apparently gets super upset with you.
Oh.
And it can straight up lock, like Bomb Teresa stops moving and everything.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Like you can hard lock the game.
Bomb Teresa's just like you think about what you've done.
Actually, I should, I had the, I'm gonna have to go look at the seed, because it's in one of my streams, but I should make sure I get the execution down so that I don't, mostly from the parts leading up to that, so I don't, like, accidentally take too long in a room and the seed fucking changes on me or something.
Yeah, that was a bad time to put this out there.
Whoops. Cody. Ooh.
Yeah, that was an interesting reset. Okay.
I'm
going
to stage 5.
I made it to the second boss once properly equipped.
Ah,
I'm not
son
making
of
it to stage 3 tonight.
Motherfucker, no missing to stage 5. The rest of us can't even beat stage 3 most of the time.
Yes.
I love this.
What I might do.
That's a skill disparity if ever I saw it.
I might actually flip over and code the multi-chat thing that I was talking about.
Nice.
That's one thing I can conceive of doing. So, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna jump off the call, at least for now.
Okay.
So, you all have a good night.
See you, Kenny.
See you, Kenny.
Take it easy.
Yep.
So, Zerst, how bad is Stage 5 for those of us who will never see it?
Bitch.
Is Stage 5 everything that Stage 4 wanted to be and more in terms of hating your life? Fuck. Video games are still hard. I don't know if you know that. Mm-hmm. Anyway, Bond, have you been practicing up on your LTTP side of things that you were ready to carry your half of a combo?
Yes, I've been doing that every week, as per the norm.
Very good.
I also did a couple scratch run-throughs of Axelay just to get the super dumb fucking laser rust out of there. And it didn't go very well, but hey, that's Axelay for you.
The super... the fucking laser.
Yeah, there might have been a dumb B5 death in the middle of that sentence.
I don't think this is possible. Whoa. Oh, maybe it is!
It's a bold try. Nice.
Boulder. Fine. The real question, though... Oh man, I actually got up here. I'm getting this Franker Z now. I actually pulled it off. I think it's only possible because I had space jump, though. Because I don't know how I would have gotten past the first bit without it. And fuck that missile, it's not worth doing more dumb bomb jump horseshit. I got the thing I care about. Also, Zerst, I'm just looking at your stream and I just see like 18 power-ups falling down. What the hell? Why are there that many power-ups right there?
Where do you think you get all the
points? There's a really annoying section in stage 5 where it speeds up and just pulls it all out.
It's just... the game basically just shrugs and like, here, have 80 power-ups, whatever, man.
That is a friend I didn't want to see. Get out of here, dude.
Wait, what?
The monster hunter. There's the monster I'm not hunting.
Oh.
Shut up. Okay, yeah, you can shoot fire off of that guy. That's fine. That's cool. Let me get my bombs out.
No! I almost got the quick kill, but I missed with the last missile.
Boom, okay, I pooped him. Use the poop correctly.
I can't respond early because I Discord set up for push to bomb, which is not convenient. Also, I accidentally picked up like 2 extra speed ups.
Oh, oops.
Your speed is currently at oh no out of 10. Got it.
Right.
Is it fast enough that it's gone to speed down? Because if you've hit where the game takes pity on you and it's saying speed down now, bad times are afoot. Mm. Oh, that's not a that's also not a damage boost. Video games are hard.
Oops.
Yeah, that. Hashtag mood.
The monster was killed.
I mean, what?
I'm just going through and off, plus I haven't done, so most of the stuff is going to be like trivial, very good at new.
I mean, you're also doing solo stuff, which is,
Yeah, to explain Monster Hunter scale, you do, right?
Yeah, one player equals, weak stats, two plus players equals fuck you stats.
So there's two stats, one player and four player. if you have more than one player, you get four player stats.
Oh, that seems like fair.
Normal stats and fuck you stats.
So funny, because me and Firetron play a lot together, so we're very used to just playing. We're used to fighting fully multiplayer scale monsters. So it's funny when I do stuff in single player, then and it's like, oh, that was easy.
Oh, that thing died in like 4 seconds. Okay, cool. Have you streamed any of your hunting monster exploits?
I have not. I could have.
I feel like people would probably watch that.
I'm sure they would.
I can't guarantee if I would watch it in large part because I may be doing other things. Like, I can't guarantee me watching anything.
Yeah, it's just Monster Hunter World really stupid, so I'll not stress my
NDing.
Like, I'm pretty sure I could, but I don't know if I could.
That's reasonable. Also, Baby Metroid went and stole all my health. What a jerk. The baby, etc.
The baby.
The baby.
Oh, whoa! That was almost a fucking near unavoidable dunk. If I were going faster when I jumped through that door, I would have jumped directly into a crab. It would have been a real bad time. Would not have recommended it.
Well, you dodged the crab, so good work.
I did. Fuck, my beer is empty. I might have to go and refill that, so I'm gonna keep crab dodging.
Alright, 10 with my Diabolos.
GLHF.
Ah.
I actually haven't fought many of Diabolos, so pretty boring.
Oh, I have 2 E-tanks rather than 1.5 E-tanks. Very good. Mm-hmm. Hey, give me energy, you fuck! I have... No. Okay, very good.
Now you got me curious whether I can stream it or not, so I'm gonna see that segment there. Yeah.
Do it! Do it!
Wait, hop back up on the multi on accident?
Yeah. I mean, the multi still includes you, so... Well, I'm hearing honking outside. People are being bad at driving again, apparently. I know, film at 11 and all, but... I feel like that's a piece of information that would surprise no one ever. People being bad at driving.
I don't know. Surely you jest.
Come on. I just want to get my long way points, okay? It says I nearly f***ed it up and not long way points.
Alright, well, I hit the button, so we'll see. Maybe. You know what? You wanna watch this guy. This stuff.
You wanna watch the what?
This OBS stuff and stuff. Okay, it's working on, you know, Hyatt, so I don't see my video rendering like 3 frames per second OBS. Say it's not dropping any frames, so I'm assuming it's not dropping any frames in reality, but.
I see reasonably animated fire.
It looks not choppy.
Well, that was like literally the most inconvenient drop and drop that we've gotten.
Yeah, I don't know. Looks pretty Monster Hunter, I guess. Nuts. From what little I know of it. Oh, those fuckers take 3 shots? Fuck that. Go over here instead.
One power up, please. Thank you.
No. You get 0.
God,
like
and I
it.
Lost it right away. Good job. Fucking fantastic. Okay.
I should have blocked. I know better. Good. Look at this.
Greed strats. Those are cool though.
I restore health when I hit monsters so I can be very greedy. Oops, that was the wrong. Yeah.
How about one more after this, please? Soon?
No.
before the boss would be preferable.
Yeah, just keep not doing anything. That's appreciated. That's appreciated.
Appreciable.
You, wow, you are being like this easy. I'm thinking to play Wax.
That was dumb.
Oh, fun. Pinch. Dang it.
You're cutting it out, I think.
Yeah, that was unless you're. That was me losing the will to speak as I was speaking. Son of a...
Very good, carry on.
Yeah, I think I'm done for tonight.
Alright, fair enough.
I think my best potential was on, well, I don't know if my 1800 once without even paying attention, but the best one was when I got to the third boss without missing any power-ups and without losing any lives, and I did something dumb and died. And that was the end of that.
Mm.
I could have been fine. I just kept getting, then I just flat out game over to the third boss. It's like, third boss had my number tonight.
It has so many weird patterns.
I'm gonna bet on the purple wavy goo shit. It seems like a strong bet.
I did actually, for the first time, get knocked out by that tonight. But only once.
Oh shit.
The rest what did I get hit by the rest of the time? I think it was the stupid, red presence.
Those will do it too.
The missiles it fucking fires while it does the little laser pattern are the worst.
It's not great.
Yeah.
It's not even the lasers that get me most of the time. It's the dumb fucking missiles that just sort of, like, here.
Just amble through, and it's like, okay, hi.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I think the first...
Jerk-ass boss.
The stupid death thing.
Oh, sir! Okay, that's fine.
Citation needed?
Missiles?
Okay,
oh, eat shit, boss! There we go.
Wait, what the?
There we go.
Okay, Bond, you need to make up your damn mind.
Hey, man, it took my dink first, and that was the no. But then it died, like, almost immediately thereafter, and like, okay, fine. Hello, stage 4. Please to give me 6 power-ups before I eat it.
Shit, you're on stage 4. Nice. What's your score looking like?
582 at current.
Ooh, that's solid. I'm a little worried now.
Oh, but actually, then we got these dudes with the fucking flamethrower ass going on. It's not fun. Oh, jeez.
I know exactly the ones you're talking about.
Yeah, see?
But the flamethrower ass is a real strong description.
It inspires the mind. You need to fucking get out of my way and not bang into me. Thank you.
Actually, no, feel free to bang into him.
Also, one more power up.
I need him to not get another Hundo K, thanks.
What did I say before? 580 something?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm at 620, so alright.
That is greedy.
I need him to not get another 60 or so K.
Oh, that's an interesting mini boss. Excuse me, have I seen you before? Probably not. I hope you're almost dead, because I'm almost dead. This dude. Okay, thank you. Well, 688 now, so...
Alright, well, rip my score, I guess.
That sure sounds like he's hungry.
Whoa, that's some lag going on.
Diablo's going to eat some cactuses.
Alright.
And he's getting shit-talked for having illegible code on his stream, and I love it. Because that's clearly where we're at now. Watch Kenny code while everyone else also plays basically a bunch of random shit at this point. Half of which isn't even shmups anymore.
Oh, see that? I'm just gonna go ahead and cut my stream here. I'll stick around and call for a little bit while things are still going on. Oops.
Ooh, that's a lot of mechs. Get out of here.
Yeah, I game over Lightning Stage 6 with
3 million. Oh, bye bye, Dink.
That's pretty good. It's a much more impressive score than I will likely come up with.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I forgot my pattern for pretty much the end of the game, which that last checkpoint's kind of a pain. You have to get rid of stuff pretty much as soon as it's on the screen.
Or it ruins you.
Right. Fuck. Basically, there's a couple planes that fire out like napalm that blocks your shots.
Oh, that sounds terrible.
Oh, shit.
That is.
And so the crap behind it just
awful.
Blows up. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not surprised that the end of the game is rude because, you know, Toaplan and all, but...
Oof. Actually, it's not that bad. It's just that one checkpoint. Like, the last boss is not that tough.
Huh.
Like, I would say, like, the third, well, not the third, the fourth boss is probably harder than the last boss.
I wouldn't know. I've never seen it.
Yeah, the third boss,
Shit.
I mean, the third boss is also a rude jerk.
Yeah, you just have to know how to fight it and, like, what it does. Depending on which weapon you have, it actually it disappears and reappears places.
This is interesting.
It'll actually dump you into, like, a safe spot for half of its attack.
Huh. That's neat.
Yeah, like, if you go into it with shot... Just basically,
oh, man.
When it disappears, just sit in the middle of the screen and don't move in the first like two attacks. It'll just completely miss you, and then it's mostly dead by then.
Oh, nice! I got the second extend. Shit.
Oh
shit! Shit! Shit!
Damn!
Oh. Wow.
Bond is showing me up on this one, then. Well done.
Get over the click.
Ah! Oh. Okay. These patterns are not being fun. Even with no rank,
wow.
I do not enjoy.
Does the rank completely reset when you die, or is it just
speed.
Like a reduction?
I don't know. I think
in what?
Resets.
In V5?
In V5.
I think it resets and then goes back up. I can actually probably figure it out pretty quick, though.
Oh, is it time for science? I love science.
Yeah, that's the thing. I can do that. I don't really have time for another credit, so I can... play around a bit and see if I can figure out what it actually does with the rank.
I like the sounds of this.
Okay, I'm just going to wait for it to roll over to the scoreboard again. And then I think I'll be done, because I am not beating that tonight.
That's well done, though. Good job, sir.
Hello's a
You're a jerk, but good job.
I pride myself on being a jerk, but also doing a good job.
Well, I can't argue with the logic, I guess.
Why doesn't it like that?
Sounds like a set of monsters goes on in this position. Get my boy Evil Joe.
There we go.
The pickle of doom.
A pickle?
A pickle, huh?
He's basically like, imagine if a T-Rex had even tinier arms and was elongated and was the color of a pickle.
Okay, that's fair.
That's interesting. It's the version I use of name for debugging. Doesn't actually like V5.
Okay, I'm gonna wrap it there. So I'll talk to y'all later.
All right, take care, Mr. Bond. Have a good night.
Yeah, Devil Joe is going to be an asshole and eating up the thing.
Okay, that'll do it for tonight. Tomorrow is podcast, so that'll start up around 7 p.m. CDT. Stream for Saturday night is still a bit up in the air, but leaning towards not. So next stream will probably for sure be Sunday night, 7 p.m. CDT. We'll be back on Cactus to get some more practice, Cactus practice, for the next marathon that's coming up in 2-ish weeks. All right, thanks for watching, everybody. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.